I'm in Munich. I'm attending the 17th symposium on acute leukemias, which is a very good symposium with all leukemias experts. And my topic today will be how and when to choose between a hypomethylating agent or intensive chemotherapy to treat a patient with AML, essentially an older patient with AML. So we do have two different treatments. One is a lower intensity with low-dose cytarabine or mostly now with hypomethylating agent. And the other one is a standard intensive chemotherapy. So we have to decide between both, which is not so easy. And we prefer to treat with a lower intensity the oldest patient with some bad risk characteristic. And probably the bad risk characteristic are more important as compared to the age itself. And these bad risk characteristics are essentially the secondary AML, the poor risk cytogenetics and poor risk gene mutation. On the other hand, if you have a patient with good risk characteristic, especially a patient with good health status and capable to receive intensive chemo, so those patients with favorable cytogenetics or favorable mutation, like NPM1 gene mutation, it's preferable to treat this patient intensively. So there is no randomized trial actually to compare these two strategies. We try to do that in one azacitidine trial, offering the opportunity to randomize between intensive chemotherapy and azacitidine, but the fraction of patients actually randomized against intensive treatment was relatively low. So we cannot base our judgment on randomized study results. So the last point, which is probably the most important one, is that beyond the characteristics, the genomic characteristic of the disease, the health status of the patient is really important. So we do have some comorbidity score for scoring comorbidities in every individual patient. And we also do have our own physician judgment, which is really important when facing the patient for the first time. We can usually quite rapidly assess its capacity to tolerate intensive treatment, yes or no. And this judgment is also of high value in our clinical decision. Yeah.